Kelsey here for another Species Spotlight. I'm here at the Native Plant Nursery, specifically at our Native and Naturalized Victory Garden. Here, we have been growing a couple different fruits and vegetables. For example, we have a Seminole pumpkin. We have some papaya right here. We have an Everglades tomato, which is what we are going to be highlighting today. We have bird pepper. You might have learned about this in our previous species spotlight. And we also have some creeping cucumber and coastal ground cherry. One thing you'll notice about this garden too are these really showy purple flowers. This is a Keys ageratum. It's an endangered epac plant. And we have them here to attract pollinators. So pollinators are important to growing vegetables and fruits because without the pollinators, we wouldn't be able to produce them in the first place. So today, like I said, we're talking about our naturalized Everglades tomato. So these teeny little dime-sized tomatoes actually come from Ecuador and Peru down in South America. They were brought north by either migratory birds or Native Americans who brought them to plant and to grow and to eat way back in the day. So they've been in Florida for a really long time and they're very well adapted to the environment here. They're very disease resistant. They're also tolerant of a lot of the different struggles that plants would have living down here. So for example, they are wind resistant. They're tolerant of high winds. They're tolerant of salt, both in the air or some in the ground. They're tolerant of drought conditions, which we have for about half the year. And like I said, they're very disease resistant too. So they're able to thrive in this environment. You'll notice that they grow, they can grow like a vine. So here we have what's called a trellis. We've made this ourselves in the nursery. And they can grow up the trellis like a vine would. They can also grow in kind of a shrub formation. If you don't have a trellis, they're happy to just spread out on the ground. It really just depends on how much space you want to allow for them. You'll notice that they're a green plant with this fuzzy stem and leaves. The leaves are actually smell really good. They have an awesome scent. And they're edible, just like the fruit, which a lot of people don't even really know about. They produce first these small yellow flowers that tend to hang downwards. After the flowers, you will get these dime-sized tomatoes. So at first they're green, like these ones over here. They'll be a little bit smaller. They'll grow in size. And by the time they turn red, you know that they're ready to be plucked and eaten. Delicious. So if you want, this is a super low maintenance plant if you live down in the Keys or in the South Florida area to add to your garden. They grow super quick. And like I said, they produce tons of these little tomatoes. I personally like to collect them when they're ready and pop them into a salad, and they're the perfect size. Some interesting facts about this. It's also called a wild tomato, so it's a wild tomato variant, as opposed to a cultivated tomato, like say the heirloom tomatoes that you might find in the grocery store. And so the genetic material is taken from wild tomatoes to eventually turn them into cultivated tomatoes that we as humans make to be bigger and have a longer shelf life, so they would last in a grocery store for a longer amount of time. So that's easier for us to sell them. But an interesting fact is that only between 2 and 5% of the genetic material found in wild tomatoes like this one, you can actually see in these cultivated tomatoes. So what that means is that they've been changed so much by us selecting different qualities that we want in that tomato, that they're very different than these tomatoes that we have today. Another name for this tomato is the currant tomato. And one other fact, so if you are to be growing these in your garden, like I said, they're a very low maintenance plant. One thing that you do want to look out for, especially when you get nice big plants like we have here, are tobacco or tomato hornworms. Now these guys are really big. They're about this big. very thick worms that have two horns on their front side, and they will just munch away at this plant. So if you find one, you want to immediately get rid of it, or else risk them eating most of your tomato plant. So thanks so much for joining me this week. I hope that you guys learned a lot. If you're interested in growing your own Everglade tomato plant, we do have them for sale here at the Native Plant Garden. We have a plant sale once a month, but if you were to stop by during the week, if Mary, our nursery manager, is here, I'm sure she would be happy to help you out.